what's going on? I'm DJ Sixsmith. You're watching The Sit Down. Jessica Kirson is here with us, brand new comedy special on Comedy Central.
Yes.
How are you?
Nice to meet you.
Good to meet you, too.
Yeah.
This was hysterical.
Thank you so much. Well, just the face?
Just the face alone. Like, when people get into your comedy, if they haven't seen you before, you're very physical.
Yeah.
You turn around, you're talking to yourself, as the name of the special is.
Yeah.
Like, this must have been a blast to put together. And the fact that you hadn't done one before, like, just blows me away.
It's crazy. It blows everyone away. It's really one of those stories, and it happens all the time, where people are very strong. Mm-hmm. They're well-known. Comics love them. The clubs love them. And then they just, they don't get a special.
Yeah.
And they gave out a lot of specials to people who weren't ready, unfortunately, and wasted a lot of money.
Yeah.
So.
Well, I feel like given that, you were definitely ready for this one.
Yes.
You knocked it out of the park.
Thank you.
I feel like you just had fun, too. Like, the crowd was really good for it. Like,
oh, they were unreal.
Yeah.
They,
I mean, you had some people heckling in there. You're playing with the crowd up front. Like,
yeah.
You had the best of both worlds.
Well, I always play with the crowd. Mm-hmm. I love doing crowd work. And I feel like some people, it's not right for their act, like
right.
Jim Gaffigan or Mike Birbiglia, you know, but for me, going in and out of the crowd just helps my stuff even more. It just makes it even funnier.
Yeah, and I'm sure it kind of breaks it up when you're doing a bunch of shows on the road and it's the same material. You don't know what you're getting from the crowd necessarily when you walk in.
No way. and I get bored of my material sometimes.
Yeah.
Sometimes I do most of my set is crowd work.
Mm, that's really interesting.
Yeah.
So when did you start doing the thing where you turned around and you were talking to yourself?
I started doing that 15 years ago maybe, but it didn't work at first. And for people that haven't seen it, it's where I realized that I only can do it when a joke doesn't work.
Mm.
Meaning, I'll do it, and if a joke doesn't work, I turn around with my back to the audience and have a conversation where I'm like, it's okay, everyone makes mistakes.
You know, like, you're comforting yourself
in
front of everybody else.
Right, but like if I was killing and then turned around, it looks like I should be in a mental institution. Like it didn't work. So it took me a long time to get that to work well.
Mm.
And now it does for the most part. There's still some people, because they're dumb and they can't understand it, so they just look at me like, what is going on? But most people get what I'm doing.
Yeah, and I'm sure you're kind of scanning the crowd to see like, all right, this person's absorbing it. And this person has no idea, or this person's super quiet for one of my jokes, and you totally point that out.
Yeah, well, comics notice the one person that's not laughing. Unfortunately, you could have 1,000 people and there's one guy just staring and you're like, dad, you know, it brings up a lot of stuff.
Yeah, it certainly does.
Yeah.
So with your special, I mean, you go into it all. By the way,
this is the most attractive picture they
could have put. This is amazing. Well, it kind of represents what the special is all about, because your comedy is so physical. So when did you realize that it was going to encompass all these different things in your life?
Well, I've been doing that. So that's my Jewish grandmother. That's my imitation. This, you know, like, you know, the second you go on stage, what is this? This is horrible. What the hell is she talking about? You know, it's that face. But I've been making those faces since I'm a kid.
Mm.
So that's what I always did well, was mimic people. And I always made my friends laugh by mimicking people, whether it was a teacher or anyone, I could mimic people. And I realized that people love to be entertained. They love high energy, they love, you know, silliness. And a lot of people now don't want to think. You know, there's always going to be those people who can't be present.
Right.
And are overthinking every single thing a comic says, which is, you might as well go bowling, because it's really ridiculous.
What are you coming for?
It's a lot now,
unfortunately.
But then most of the crowd will sit and just listen and be entertained, and they can be silly.
And just laugh also,
and
allow themselves to really let loose, because like you say in your special, there's some uncomfortable moments when we're doing impressions of people, and like, sometimes we're looking around, we don't feel like we can laugh, but like,
well, I address
at a special,
that,
you
which
it.
I love that I do, and I taught comedy for many years, and I used to tell comics, you have to address when something's not working.
Right.
So there are a lot of comics, especially ones where they're starting out, where they'll be like bombing, and they're like, so anyway, I'm like, no, you need to address it's not
right
going well.
It,
you need bomb lines.
Yeah.
That's what I call them.
Mm.
And it helps, it redirects the energy in the room. Everyone's just down and miserable or not laughing, and then all of a sudden you get their attention when you address what's really going on.
What were the biggest challenges of putting your special together?
Well, it's very hard. You know, most comics don't look at their stuff and be like, my stuff is amazing.
Mm.
You know, it's very hard to feel good enough about it. It's very vulnerable to put out your material that you've worked on for 20 years to just show it
especially
to the
world. Especially when it's your life. You know,
yeah, it's not
like,
nuts.
You're poking fun at, you know, UFOs and people in the South and stuff, but then it's like your relationships, your family, your grandma.
Everything,
there's a lot of stuff.
A lot.
Yeah.
You're right. It's a lot. And there's going to be, most people really get what I do, and there's going to be some people where they just, and I get it online, every comic, every entertainer does, where this isn't funny, why are they giving her, it's... That's really hard to open yourself up and know that you are going to get attacked. Like, the more successful you get, the more you get attacked.
Right.
You do get a lot more fans, but again, comics normally look at the negative. So I have to not do that.
Do you think you can ever stop looking at the negative?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's gotten much easier
much
for
better.
Me because I've realized how is that going to help me?
It's not going to help at
it's
all.
It's not.
Yeah.
And it's not going to inspire me. It's not going to make me work harder. It's not. It's just going to make me miserable. And it's so interesting. It's not as much what they're saying that it hurts me. Mm-hmm. It's more that it makes me not like. It makes me feel like there's no humanity, like people are just mean-spirited, and that's very upsetting. Like, I just don't understand mean-spiritedness. I would never, ever go on the computer and comment negatively about someone, ever. I never have. So it's hard for me to comprehend it.
It really reveals what's going on in that person's life. Like, the fact that you have to watch something and then go to the computer to comment, like, it's just ridiculous.
It's really, it's sad.
It is sad.
And it's gonna get worse.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I mean, listen. You put yourself out there with a special. You'll take it out. But like, you killed it. That's all you need to know.
Thank
you.
You
were awesome with it.
Thank you so much.
And the crowd really responded to it too.
They did. They did. I ended up having incredible crowd, and I was so happy. They totally got it. They normally do. You know, I've always been a crowd pleaser, but I purposely do that. Like, I give 100%, and I feel like if people pay, they deserve a show. Like
definitely.
A show. Like, it's not, it's selfish for me to just be half-assed, be like, whatever. They're paying for it, so they deserve to laugh.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Obviously, it takes a ton of time to weave everything together. Are there certain sections you're most proud of when you think about the construction of the special? Like, just the parts that you enjoyed the most in terms of just doing your thing up there?
Well, for me, it's the crowd work, because you know, that's always comes out of nowhere.
The
other stuff I'm so used to doing, but when I do crowd, that's the one time I always think it's funny. Like, I don't go, oh, my material's funny, and laugh at my material. But when I do crowd work, I'll laugh at what I did. Like, I think it's crazy.
Right, so like when you're asking the guy what he does for work.
That's what I was
referring to. And then you burp it. And like, you're just
I
like,
have
if
to
I'm
say
that
that's
guy.
The funniest part
absolutely.
Of my thing.
It's
for me.
You weren't expecting it.
I didn't expect it. I did for a second think, should I do this or not? Because of course, it's, can you imagine?
Right.
I just burp all the time out of nowhere. But he was taking a little while to answer me, and then I just burped, and it was such a risk to do that.
Sure.
Because the crowd could be like, but I laughed when I did that because
that's
it was
good.
Insane.
It was.
Like most female comics would never, no one would do that. That's what I love.
But then you also peppered in there with like, gosh, I'm starving. Like I haven't eaten anything. I should have eaten a protein bar. We're building, and then boom, you just belched multiple times.
I know. You know what? I also love testing the audience. Like when I say I should have eaten more, you know, again, a lot of people get it, like you, because you're aware and you're educated.
Totally.
But some people are like, why is she telling us she should have eaten? They don't get it. And it's so much fun for me to watch them confused.
Yes.
I don't know why, it makes me laugh.
Well, it's kind of like with the old people situation in Florida. I mean, people are coming up to you and like, hey, great job, but
I'm just gonna trash you. There's
here.
Always a negative, you know, you were very funny, but no one around me laughed. I heard someone cough, but no one laughed.
I enjoyed the card game joke with the older women when they're describing
who
you
are. Oh, the
bees. Yes.
Yeah, that's a favorite. People love. People love that joke. Yeah, when I act out old women, you know, I say I went to visit my grandmother, and all these old women, they sit around, they sound like bees, like these old Jewish women, like salmon, you know. And I went to visit my grandmother, and she wasn't there. This is a true story. And I went up to her friend Rona, and I said, Rona, do you know where my grandmother is? And she goes, I don't know, darling, but I'll let her know you were looking for a trust fund. So I walked away, and I heard her yell out, this is totally true. That's B. Fobman's granddaughter. She's a lesbian magician. Yeah. Yeah. It's a... That's why people say, where do you get your material? I'm like, just listen.
Life.
Right.
Yeah.
Look around.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then you have your experience with your dog, which you talk about when you're taking a crap outside.
Oh, my God.
House.
That's one I cannot believe I did on live. I'm serious, on television.
I mean, you go a ton of different places, but that one.
I still can't believe that I did that.
It's a wild story.
Well, I mean, I'm not going to say the whole thing, but I was drunk and my friends, we went outside to smoke cigarettes. I was a teenager. Mm-hmm. And, oh boy, I ended up pooping on my mother's lawn, but it was all for attention because I was really filled with self-hatred and just wanted to be liked. And they loved it. My God, my friends, we were all drunk and they were laughing. But my mother ended up blaming it on the dog and she put his nose in my crap. It was really upsetting.
Poor dog.
Yeah, I know. I never saw him after that. Mm. He ran away.
I could understand.
Yeah.
So when people check out the special, there's obviously a ton to digest. What are some of the big things you want them to think about, laugh about, et cetera?
I just want people to let go and be silly and not be so serious. You know, I'm a humanitarian. I love people. I want people to be okay. I'm such an empath, but I also want people to let go and stop being so sensitive and triggered and, oh my God, it's like, just have fun in life. It's you have to, or else you're gonna get sick. Mm. Like, it's not a good thing. And I want to lead them to other stuff I do. I have a podcast called Relatively Sane, which I love, and I've interviewed a ton of big comics, and I have a ton of videos online and silly stuff. And I really just want people to get out of their heads and just laugh.
I think other comics get it. Like, it makes sense to me that, like, Bill Burr would be somebody that takes a liking to you because he's also somebody that's always pushed boundaries. Dave Chappelle continues to push boundaries. Like, we need those people. Tiffany Haddish is with what she did. Like, having other comics bringing people in. Like, because in other industries, people get so competitive. But with comedians, they look to help each other out.
They
do. I love.
And
I awesome.
Love that I love that most of the comedians really respect me because I push boundaries. Like, it's like, if you try to silence me, it's gonna get bad.
Mm. And it's not gonna be a good situation.
It's nuts. Like, the crowd was very uptight at the Comedy Cellar in New York last week, and there's a band on stage on the weekends, and I ended up singing a gospel song as a big black woman, because they were so politically correct. I was like, you're too uptight. Like, I did this whole, and a lot of people laugh, but some white people, you know, black people die laughing.
Right, they're digging it, but
the white people are like, oh my God, is this okay?
Right.
It just shows you what's going on.
Even the one part where you're like, oh, I hope there are no Blasians in the audience.
Oh,
like,
yeah, I know. Black, Asian. Everyone's so crazy. Yeah. I'm Jewish, and Jewish people really laugh at themselves. So I was brought up differently.
You have to laugh at yourself. Life is difficult. It's crazy. Like, we got to laugh about these things.
Yeah.
And we definitely laugh with this.
Oh, thank you.
That was awesome. Really nice
thank
to meet
you so much.
Thanks so much.
Thank
Why don't you tell everybody when they can check it out, where they can check it out, the whole
thing? Yeah, so I'll be on Comedy Central at midnight tonight, and then they can check it out online or on the Comedy Central website tomorrow. And my Tonight Show is re-airing tonight
cool.
at the same
time
on Jimmy Fallon. And my podcast is Relatively Sane. Keep in touch.
Good deal. Yeah. Jessica, I'm DJ. See you next time. You're on the Sit Down.